Just go to the Docker website and for the instruction we are installing this thing. Yeah, Ubuntu, right? So just I will create an account. Adding is there. I'm giving a name as Jenkins user. I will switch to the user.
Hello, sorry for interrupting.
Yeah.
What is the user at Jenkins? You're installing.
Just adding the user into the system. It's a basic command. You need to add that user. Since it's a root privilege, I'm working on root privilege. I don't want to work on root privilege, so I'm using that Jenkins user. Now I'm switching to that Jenkins user.
So Jenkins is also installed in the tower in order to use Jenkins to work.
Sorry.
Now you're adding, there is a command, right? User@Jenkins.user.
Yeah.
Okay, so in order to work that command, you need to install Jenkins or what I'm asking. It's already installed or what?
No, no, you can use any user. Any username, just imagine adding this user.
Okay.
So what I did here is just add that user Jenkins underscore user, and then I have created a directory for the home directory for the particular user. So under home, then I will create a Jenkins with the name Jenkins. It's just a directory, nothing else. And then I'll try to switch that user. Then I am unable to see the directory. So I have user mod. So in order to assign the directory which I have created over here to the particular user, so I have this the user mod hyphen d is the directory. This directory I have assigned to the Jenkins user. This user. Now I try to switch to that user from the root, and as you can see, once again I'm getting into this shell since I need the bin bash. So it's a shell, only shell. So I tried to switch, assign that bin bash shell to the user, and then I switched. Now I am in Jenkins user. Now presently working directory is home under Jenkins. Now I'm installing as per the document over here. I will add that HTTPS directory. Actually, I didn't give the password for the user Jenkins. was it updated? Okay. I'll add that user into the loop privilege. Sudo user. I'm giving the Jenkins user as a pseudo privilege. Now it won't ask for the password for the Jenkins user. Right and quit. Now I switch to the Jenkins user and yeah. Now I'll install that certificate. I'll find that key, that Docker official key for just checking the fingerprints. Adding that thing, then I'm trying to add the Docker, which is a stable version. Only the stable version I'm going to add. Okay, that is added. The stable version of the Docker is added into that repository. Now I'm updating again. Updating the repository. And then here I'm installing this Docker C community edition. This is the community edition, is the free one. Then we have a Docker app 2 edition, that is one is community edition, that is the Docker C, and another is Docker enterprise edition, which is paid one. Now it's installing. Okay, let's start. Okay. Now Docker is installed, we can check. Docker ps no doc okay Docker version command can check. Now that's the Docker client, and now it's unable to communicate with the Docker server on the docker.socks. So if I try to run the Docker ps command is to check the running container. So it won't allow you to check communicate with the server. This is a client machine. Docker has client server architecture. Now the client machine can access. There is a client machine that is CLI of the Docker, and it's unable to communicate with the Docker server. So why it's unable to communicate? When we install Docker, it will create a group with the name Docker. Let's check that. As you can see, this I didn't create this Docker group. It's automatically created when I install the Docker Docker and install this Docker CI. So in order to communicate with the Docker server, Docker has some security limitation, like only those users who are in the Docker can communicate with that Docker server. So right now, as you can see, OMI is the command which will give the currently logged in user as, I'm currently logged in as the Jenkins user. So I need to add this Jenkins user into this Docker group. So in order to do so, I need to execute user mod command and append group. Group is the Docker group. I want to add into the Docker group. My user is this user. So now when I execute this command, now you can see that the Jenkins user, which I'm currently logged in, is added into the Docker group. As you can see in the previous command, previously I didn't, the currently using Jenkins user is not added, but now it's added after executing this command. So now if I execute Docker PS, so it's not come into effect. I need to exit and log in back. Now none of the container is currently running. So if I execute Docker version, as you can see, this is the client machine. Now it's communicated to the Docker server. Now both the versions are the same and these things. So these are how we have installed Docker. And then moving forward, Docker info command. This will list all the information like container. Right now, currently, no container is running, so it's in a zero. None of the container is running, call the stop container. Nothing is there. Currently, newly installed one. And this is the networking settings, storage, so I'm inactive. So these are the things. And so these are installed Docker.